this video, I want to talk about five things that you need to do that will get you a distinction in your grade 12 mathematics. But before that, I want to let you know that this channel is featuring videos in mathematics, physical science, life science, mathematical literacy, technical mathematics, technical science, and other subjects. You also find videos on study tips, motivational videos, and videos about life that will help you succeed in your studies and in life. So if you wanna have these videos coming your way, don't forget to subscribe and activate the notification bell so that you can be notified every time there is a new video. So I'm gonna give you a list of the five things that you need to do that will guarantee you not only a pass, but a pass with a distinction in your grade 12 mathematics. And these are things I know from experience that if you can actually take these things to heart and start doing them, I pretty much guarantee you that you will end up with a distinction in math. The first thing, number one, I'll say is to take good note, even if you don't understand what your teacher is writing on the board. That way, at least, you can have the notes, and when you get home, make sure you go over the notes. Make sure you dissect those notes and go through them line by line. I strongly discourage you to memorize your teacher's steps from solved problems, or try to memorize steps from solutions in books. Instead, try to understand how did they move from one step to the next step and why that problem is solved that way. You don't study math by memorizing steps. The secret to getting a distinction in your grade 12 math is to solve as many problems as you can from each topic. So number one, take good notes. Number two, I'll say do your homework and assignment. Take them seriously. Don't do them fast just for the sake of finishing and submitting, while leaving some questions out because you cannot figure out how to tackle a specific question from a specific topic. If you can't answer certain questions, go to your textbook or your study guide or your workbook or videos on YouTube and study that specific topic. See how examples and problems are solved in the textbook or in the study guide or in the workbook or in the videos on YouTube. Redo the problems on your own without looking at the solutions. I believe you'll come across a problem that will help you understand how to answer the question at hand. So I want to remind you that you can also get help from this channel. So feel free to send your questions when you need assistance. Please do subscribe and activate the notification bell so that you can have videos coming your way. By subscribing, you are encouraging us to keep posting great content. So don't forget to subscribe and activate the notification bell. So number two, do your homework and assignment. Number three, I will recommend you use the following textbook. The first one is Math Handbook and Study Guide by Kevin Smith. If you can't get this one, you can use this one, Platinum Mathematics Learner's Book, Grade 12. Or if you can't get this one, you can use this one, Clever Keeping Math Simple, Grade 12 Learner's Book. Now, together with any of those three textbooks, you can also buy Mind Action Series Mathematics Grade 12 textbook, or you can get ACID Study Guide Grade 12 Mathematics. So get any from these three textbooks I've suggested and any from these two textbooks I've suggested. In total, you should have two textbooks. These are very good textbooks which are used by Grade 12 learners and teachers. And also you can get this textbook for free, or these files for free on the internet. You have the Mind the Gap Study Guide Grade 12 Mathematics via Africa Mathematics Study Guide Grade 12 Mathematics by Siavula. So I have provided links to some ebooks which you can get for free on the internet. Please check them and download them. Number 4, solve as many past exam papers, starting by solving the most recent past exam papers. I will recommend you solve at least 50 papers for paper 1 and 50 papers for paper 2. If you can do more than that, that is even better. I know this seems excessive and it requires time and work on your side, but if you wanna get a distinction in grade 12 mathematics, think about how much it means to you. Are you willing to make that sacrifice? So do as many past exam papers. This will get you used to the way exam questions are set. Trust me, it is totally worth it. So I have provided links to website with past exam papers for you in the video description. Check them and download them. Number 5, consult with your teacher or make use of YouTube videos. If you don't understand something, consult with your teacher. Teachers are there to help you. So if you are watching a YouTube video, make notes from the video as you watch. Pause the video, rewind the video if you want to make notes. That is the beauty of videos, because if you are in class, most of the time, it is really hard to write down everything the teacher says and pay attention at the same time. So consult with your teacher or make use of YouTube videos. That is number 5.